Hello, hello. Yes, it's Soul Reaver. You've not gone mad. I've decided to redo part three because the audio was quite terrible. At the time, I was like, nah, it's okay. It's not that bad. And I've since realized, yes, it really is. Also, the thing is, it was after I edited the video, like a few hours later, that I thought to myself, I don't remember saving. And you know what? No, I hadn't saved. And I had to play that section all over again. I should have taken it as a sign. The perfect opportunity was right there to re-record, and I ignored it. And of all the sections to have to redo, it's Zeffen's Lair. That is like on par the worst section. Compared to the lighthouse area. So here we are, for quality reasons, I am re-recording it. So last time I kind of messed up anyway. I ended in the wrong place and messed up the continuity. This time I have just done the first confrontation with Kane and have not turned off my console. So this is the very starting point that would leave off in part two. So now we have the Soul Reaver. Yeah, boy. And if we come to the door, we notice this door has pictures of the Reaver on it. Anything with pictures of the Reaver, you can use the action button and you can interact with that. So, we're now heading to Zeffon's Lair, brother number two. So we just need to get out of here first. Hey, look, I went round in a circle. Oh my God.
Your brother Zeffon's keep lies far to the east, beyond the ruins that greeted your first exit from the underworld. He and his brood have cocooned themselves in a derelict cathedral, having murdered its human guardians.
Alrighty. So Zeffon's Lair is kind of near the training area section. So you do need to shift to come through the door. So you'll probably recognize where we are. Or just hop the gap. So we're currently heading to the first point where we shifted into the physical realm. Right here. So it comes straight across, and we've got this gate, and we couldn't come through here the first time we were here because we needed Melkaya's ability. But now we can phase through gates. Also, even once we had Melkaya's ability, we couldn't come through here before defeating Kane anyway. Well, not that we defeated him, but we had, a battle. Because we needed the Soul Reaver to get into Zephon's lair. So we've come all the way to the end, and this is where the portal is. And the first thing I'm going to do is just activate the warp gate in this area. So we come into the cave, climb on up. We've got a couple of humans, so don't kill them, don't forget. You can if you want, but if you don't have your Soul Reaver, or if your health is low, you can use the humans to top your health right up to full. So that's a thing. If you don't kill them, they won't attack you. Okie dokie.
These guys always look like they're fighting. Stop it! Stop fighting! So now let's head on over to the front door.
Alrighty, so again, we got the Soul Reaver on this door. Shift to enter. And the portal to shift back is on the right hand side, just over here. And you do have a couple of enemies. Don't forget, if you get hit, you lose the Reaver. Ow, okay. Ow. Okay, so we've already lost the Reaver. So, in the material realm, your health will keep going down. It will slowly deplete unless you are in possession of the Soul Reaver. So that's where we're headed on up to right now. So we need to jump on the rooftops, and right here is where we start climbing. So be aware that down in this section there is a Zephonim. So if you stand there for too long, he will find you. I hear him. So I'm kind of just going along here. You kind of get the gist of what needs to be done, where to go. So you don't have to come up to here, but I do want to grab this. Even if you have your Soul Reaver, I recommend grabbing this, because I would have grabbed this anyway. Okay, and here we are, just straight over to here.
And the main reason for this stick is for that. Oh, just missed out on getting my Reaver back. Never mind. And don't forget, if you don't eat the soul of the enemy, it is less likely to respawn. Some of them will, some of them won't.
Once a testament to mankind's defiance of Cain's empire, this towering cathedral now stood derelict. The humans who worshipped here, dead for centuries. Its architects conceived this tower as a holy weapon against the vampire menace, a colossal instrument of brass and stone. The cathedral's pipes, once tuned to blast a deadly hymn, now stood silent, and these vacant spaces whistled their impotence.
Okie dokie, so in here, let me just point out, down this gap, you don't want to fall down there, because for now, there's no way back up. You have to follow the passage down there, and it will lead you back to the area where we were jumping on the rooftops. So you'll have to do that all over again. And the first rule of Soul Reaver, if you're stuck, shift. Because things move about like so, so just hop on up and follow the pipe, and I tend to sneak along it because I won't fall off.
So yes. Sneaky sneak sneak.
Alright. So don't forget, you need full health to be able to shift to the material realm. I'm going to try and make it so you can see the pipes moving. I don't know if this is a good angle. There you go, you saw that one anyway. Looks cool. So anyway, just hopping along the ledges. And over here, door number one. We don't want to go through that yet because there is nothing to do just yet. Come around here, careful not to fall off. It's very easy to get stuck on nothing. So there is a switch. Use the switch. So this thing has lowered and it's not very obvious that you actually need to stand on this. So that just weighs it down and locks it into place. And come around the corner, we have door number two. So let's head on in. Follow it round, and at the end, we will need to shift because there is a barred gate and some Zephanim. Dokie. What was that? Okay. Going to use the force glyph. Because I can. Okay. It's getting intense. I knock him off. Ah, yes, he went under the block. That's the thing. Sometimes you can roll the blocks onto the enemies, and that kills them, so that's good. So, block puzzles. Many block puzzles. So this one block, I pulled it away from the wall, and then I flipped it. That is what you need to do to get it into this high gap, and then push it back to the wall and lift it up. If it's in the wrong placement, then Raziel will not lift that block. So, pretty straightforward, just finish off the patterns.
So this dungeon is all about the block puzzles, so I will be speeding up a lot of that.
Also another thing, after a while the enemies will come back, so just be aware of that. So this is behind door number one, so we do have a switch on the wall, but we couldn't reach it, but now we can. So that's the reason for not going in there to start with, we just couldn't do anything in there. But now we can. So let's head on over. Okie dokie, be careful of the ledge again. Don't want to fall off. Okay. So down the corridor leading to the bottom here, there are enemies. And they like to hide behind the corners. Whoa. Okay. Pull the lever. And now we have a second dealy. Where's the other guy? There he is. They're usually waiting right by the switch to take a chunk out of you. So let's go and weigh this one down. So that has produced a jet of air, and that will take us up to the top. We also had a new command there. If you hold down R1 specifically for the PlayStation, Raziel will descend very slowly. Okie dokie. So hop on up. And you can follow this around, but I'm gonna hop up here. We have a bell right here. And directly across the way, straight ahead, there is another bell. We want to hit both of these bells. Oh, come on, you can do it. There you go. And in a way, they are timed. You want them both to be ringing out at the same time. So that is directly opposite. That window that we've just broken is close by, it's not too far away, we will be getting there. And also I want to point out this doorway, it's closed for now, so we will get back to that as well. So now just keep coming clockwise around this area through the door. Keep on going, and then through this door.
Now we have some human enemies, and they are different to the ones we previously encountered because they are in a dungeon lair. They will attack you regardless. They are not your friend.
We have yet more block puzzles. So once you shift, I am going to get this off the wall. I've lost my reaver, but it's okay, I have this stick. And to safety, collect the soul, get in my belly. There we go, I have the soul reaver back. So I'm just getting a stick because it's useful to be able to have one of these, or a form of weapon, if you don't have your reaver and you take too long doing the block puzzles and the enemies come back. But those particular sticks take a while to get off the wall, which is infuriating. So there we go, just push the entire stack of blocks over to there and then we can separate them. So just push each block. So this room is really straightforward. This first one, you just want to flip it twice and it goes straight in there.
I won't bother explaining what I'm doing for every single one. I will just speed up the video. You'll figure it out.
Thank you. So far, we have no idea what these are, but we've just given access to one of them. But we've done what we need to do here, so let's just shift and leave. Okay, so when we shift here, there will be that guy right there. So let's quickly get out of here. So I do ignore a lot of enemies because it's more hassle if you end up losing the battle and losing your Reaver. Also, there is that first bell we rang. Keep on going. And then through this door. Could you door, please? Thank you. Do you even door? Okie dokie, come on in to more block puzzles. So there is a stick right down below, but I think a Zephanim will spawn right there. There is also a stick there, but I believe a Zephanim is right there as well. Can't remember. Damn, you've seen me. Get the stick! God, you lost your chance. Come on, I was trying to do the menu and the menu wasn't coming up. I can't use that either. There, look, stick. And it's kind of rude that, you know, I'm trying to attack one of them and the other one attacks me. Outrageous. Stick, 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 there. Oh my goodness. Right. I've lost my Reaver. Anyway, block puzzles. So don't forget, you know the block is in place when you hear it click. Stick.
So if you lose your Reaver and are struggling, you can always shift to the spectral realm and then shift back again and you will get your Reaver back.
Okie dokie, so that's another one of those things we've given access to. Oh, I need sustenance. Okie Okie dokie. So, yet again, come on out. And right here, there is a crank. This space in front was where that giant window was that we smashed. So, this crank opens up that door. But, in a theory, in a way, it's timed. So there is no way you can actually get to that door in time. The intention is that you shift and it freezes the door. So you want to shift pretty quick. So shooting out that window has given us a shortcut. Here we go. And I'm just going to point out that when you shift back to material, this big block will go back into place and we will be stuck in here, which is absolutely fine. If you want to get out, there is that wheel on the wall you can interact with, and that will keep the door open permanently. But we don't need to actually go anywhere else. This is the way to go now. We won't be coming back this way. Also, straight ahead is the actual way we will be wanting to go. But up here, this is where the portal is. And also, this is the way to a piece of health. A piece of pie. So just shift and make your way straight to that door, because there is a guy that will throw stuff at you. So you hop the gap. In between the gap is where that lower bell was that we rang. More guys around the corner. And these Zeppelin haven't heard you walk in, so let's just shift, you know, just to be quieter. So inside this is the health piece that we will be collecting, but we need to open this thing up first. So you come on in to here. Come on, there you go. What are you doing? Get in there. Alright, so where's the portal? There it is. There are no enemies within this room, and no enemies will spawn in this room, so that's very awesome. So you've got four blocks to start with that we're going to be interacting with, and once those four are in place, we will have four more. So it's simple enough for now.
I feel very out of practice with this. I'm sure there's a quicker way of doing this puzzle. Also, just a quick note, on my original recording, a Zeppelin managed to glitch through the wall. If this happens to you and it hits you, you will have to shift in order to get your Reaver back, as there are no weapons in this room.
Okie dokie. Now we have four more blocks. So just get this one out of the way to start with. Thank you. Okie dokie. So now we can collect what I think is the sixth piece of pie. Come on. You only have to walk into it. Okay, so the portal is right here. And so are the Zephanim. So it'd be quick to get out of here. Also, enemies behind every door, don't forget this. So just come back the way you came, pop the gap again. If you fall down the gap, you will have to redo that crank section and pull the crank again. Okay, so come through here. And there is a Zephanim on the ground. I want to follow the pipe, there's also one on the pipe. Oh no! Fell. Start from the bottom of the pipe. Okie dokie. So follow this along. I'm just gonna point out something. Over here, there is an enemy around the corner. Around it, any corner for that matter. There he is. Don't forget the sparkly enemies will take off your health. So, just here. This is quite interesting because we have these humans here, the nice humans. And just below the torch on the wall and above the entrance, you can't really see it too well, but there's three pipes there that they've just suddenly cut off, and I feel as though it would go higher in this room, but it doesn't. Like, it is roofed, whatever the word is. So this is a strange room. And also, there is a fire. That's a thing if you have your fire reaver.
Sorry, buddy, but I lost my reaver and I want it back.
So, yeah, what I just did with that human. That's how you get your soul reaver back. It puts your health back up to however much you need it to be without eating a soul and getting just a particular amount of health. Also, gonna point out right here, there is a blocked off section. Like, you come in here and it like forks off, but this is a dead end this way, so that's an interesting deleted bit. I mentioned loads of deleted stuff right at the very end of the game, so yes, this would be a section you come back to. And now here we are at these funny looking things. So they're actually handles, and from the angle you're given when it's showing you what you've done by doing the block puzzle. I always thought these were on the ceiling when I first played. It just seemed weird. But anyway, here they are. So we need to still do these other two. Something else. Stairs leading up to another blocked off section. Like, how much stuff got cut from the game? Or not necessarily cut, but just didn't even get added in, I suppose. Maybe, possibly. Anyway, shift on through to here. I said shift, I meant phase through the gate. Just here, you can go left or right, doesn't matter which, because you need to do both anyway. Worried about running into an enemy. Kind of cheating by being on here. I don't care. Anyway. Right here, you want to lift up two lids, and you don't really know which two. But, because there's three lids. But you want this middle one and the furthest one. Okay, so that one was far easier than a block puzzle.
Okay, and the next side, we've got exactly the same situation.
Okay, there are humans and they do throw stuff at you.
Rude.
Alright, so again, there's three. You want to lift two. You want this middle one and this closer one. Oh, penis. There you go. Nice. Now we can go and interact with all four of those. And we do just need to do a tiny bit of backtracking to find a portal. Okay, and back we go. Righty dokey. So, just interact with all four of them. Come on. Alrighty, so that has produced more airflow. And on the way up here, there are two pipes. Whoops. That you need to push. And that's because later on we will get even more airflow, but we'll need all the pipes to be connected. If you have gone through the hassle of sorting out the airflow, but nothing's happening, you need to come back and find these pipes. Get up there. Alrighty. And now over to here. So this is showing us there are handles on the ground and there's that big thing. Also, there's that. That's three separate pipes. So yeah, I got hit, but that's okay because we need to shift very soon. We want to interact with these and it'll open up this big thing, like a wall. There we go. So now we can proceed that way. Come on. What was that? You will make a perfect ballerina. So, over to here. You need to shift to bring this ledge straight down to you. And now we can come over this way. Oh, come on. Camera angle keeps moving around and it's starting to get on my nerves. So we need some health in order to shift. These guys want to come play. Oh my god, I hate these guys. Yeah, you better run. Yeah, just stay over there. Okay. So, we need to interact with that wheel straight ahead, and once we shift, there will be two Zephanim right here behind Raziel in this corner. So just run over to that wheel. Whoa, he tried. There we go. So now you can see that pipe a little bit better, and we've activated one of them. shift back to avoid the Zeppelin. Now come on up this side. Just hop up here. Oh, okay, didn't think I was gonna make that. Okie dokie. And we have a bell here. You do not want to ring this bell because that alerts the Zeppelin in the pods. How horrible is that? It's disgusting. Yeah, and they jump out of their pods to come and attack. So don't ring that bell. As I've said, it's better off to avoid the enemies, thinking you'll just get some health, and then you end up being worse off. So from here, you want to just try and hop onto this yellow thing.
Grab a stick, because these guys...
I don't know if these guys have seen me. That would be a yes, because otherwise he would be impaled. So there is a second guy, be aware of that. There he is. Actually, I'm not gonna... Yes, I will, because I impaled the guy. So he will come back if I take his stick. Wow, that was kind of obnoxious. What were you attacking, Raziel? That was the wall.
Raziel, go home. End your quest now. Right, then you need to pull this block out and you're gonna break some stuff, but that's alright because no one's looking. It's fine. Shush, don't tell anyone.
You want to drag this over to the yellow thing. Oh, okay. Okay, yeah, the Zeppelin do that and it's creepy and gross. Anyway, you want to turn this wheel. So that's activated a second pipe. Also, you kind of do want to get the block over to the wall because we're going to have to return back that way. So this block is how we're going to get up, but it's difficult with these two morons.
It's hard to tell which enemies are the worst in this game. They all suck. Except the Melkihim. They just seem to saunter about like they've got the rest of their undead lives ahead of them.
So another trick to try if you're having trouble. It doesn't always work for me, I do struggle. But if you roll the block onto an enemy, if it's on the other side, that will... Well, I say will. It should kill it. I'm not going to say it's 100% successful. Just on the off chance that it's not working and you're wondering why, and you're going to blame me saying, use it, it would work. So anyway, come up to where you pulled the block from. That's why we broke all that stuff. Lots of enemies. That was outrageous. Okie dokie, so it showed us the third wheel. So come to here, hop up here, come along. Don't want to fall off, just gonna sneaky sneak sneak along. And now along to this pipe, and when you run out of space, just glide around. And here is the third wheel. Alright, so now we have the full air pressure, but that giant pipe right there isn't in place. So we need to put that in place. Also, if you didn't do the same to that other two pipes that I have already done, you will have to go back and find them. So that has increased the air pressure. So now we can use that. So let's head on back. No, don't land on him. Well, it doesn't matter anyway. I've already lost my Reaver. So that's the reason for trying to put this block in place to start with. It's an easy path straight back. Are likely to come back. Some don't. It's very specific ones. But some enemies don't, and some do. So just hurry on up to here. It's climbing the wall. So you can jump onto the pipe now, and then just glide on up. So you want to bring Raziel forward, and he will land here. And this is it. This is the path to the boss on the way to Zephon. But first, just take a right turn and there is a warp gate in here. I'm not going anywhere, I'm just activating it. You can do it after the battle, but if you're not so good at playing and you end up dying, it's just a shortcut back. It's Zephon time. All right. Getting tense. Here we are. So let me first point out these two halves of this one guy. This poor unfortunate guy. And there is fire. That will be important. So come on in and just take a look at Zephon. Like, it's just weird and ugly.
Zephon, your visage becomes you. It's an appropriate reflection of your soul.
And you are not his handsome Raziel anymore. His precious firstborn son turned betrayer. You have missed so many changes, little Raziel. Look around you. See how the human's weapon of destruction has become my home. Indeed, my body. A cocoon of brick and granite from which to watch a pupating world.
A crevice in which to cower, only scuttling from the shadows to devour a victim already ensnared in your cowardly trap. But you've made the mistake of leaving me unbound, and it is you who must succumb to my will.
Will, instinct, reflex action. the insect mind finds little difference. I warn you, brother. As my stature has grown, so it is matched by my appetite. Step forward, morsel.
Okie dokie. So, Zephin's legs, I assume they're legs, they will come down and stab you. You can attack them and get rid of them. And you can also attack Zephin's pod. I think pod is accurate, unless you're going to be naughty about it and call it something dirty. yes, you can attack that. You don't do damage, but if when you hit him, he produces a seed. Come here, you are down. So there we go. It's far easier to hit these with the Reaver. But just try and grab this because he hits you if you go near him. I'm trying to... Ow. Oh my god! I can't believe that! He's trying to pick up the seed and also, yeah, it's gone now. I was trying to explain that the seed is kind of on a timer. It will explode after a while. Come here. So there's that one. Okay, so where's one? We want to set it on fire. And then throw it. Oh, well, not over the. He's supposed to aim. He automatically aims. Last time I practiced, I did really well and I thought, yeah, I'm definitely ready to record. Oh, god damn it. So I think when you attack with claws, you need to hit one time more. That's how it seems to be. Ow! No! No, that's embarrassing! I shifted! I died! Oh my god! Pretend that never happened. Can we pretend this didn't happen? Come here! Okay. So, I have died. And not hit Zephin at all. Doing well. Well, at least I got my Reaver. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Not losing my Reaver that bloody quick. So you can hit the pod. That's a thing. Doesn't seem to have produced a seed though. There we go. Give me a seed. Yes, 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 yes. So set it on fire. Throw it at Zephin. Okay. First one. He missed. That's good. And I hit him. That's good. Get your seed quick. Yes. Okay, this is the run. This is the real run now. Okay. I don't know if I got him. Oh, I did! He's giving me a seed. You missed. Give me the seed! Ugh. How am I doing so much better now? Just all of a sudden. Whoa! He got me, but that's fine. It's okay. There we go.
Zephon's apostate soul has bestowed on you a new gift. Like his vampire spawn, you're able to scale certain walls which are otherwise impassable, but only in the physical realm. In the spirit world, these insubstantial edifices will not support you.
So I'm just going to point out there is this door here and that door there, and these don't do anything. I've seen screenshots on the internet of these doors open, and behind them is like a little tube with a soul coming out of it, very much like in the training area in the underworld. Like, you eat a soul and then another soul will appear. So I have no idea what that's all about, no idea to open these just don't open. So that's clearly stuff that was going to happen but didn't.
In the mountains beyond the pillars, Nosgoth's cataclysms have exposed an ancient crime. Endowed with Zephon's soul, you may now progress where your path was hitherto impeded.
Okay, so also in the final part, I mentioned various deleted slash stuff that didn't even make it that far into the game. And I'm gonna go and point out something else, because now, from Zephon, we have the ability to climb. So I'm gonna make my way over to something else and show you this. Oh, have I gone completely the wrong way? I have. So when you climb this, you want to be more to the right hand side, because at the top it doesn't allow you to actually get off the ladder because of the placement of the wall. So I believe I also, when I was explaining deleted stuff, I got a bit mixed up on the order. The order is you would defeat Cain for a third time, and then you would do the section known as the Pinnacle of Silence. And you actually, I believe, lift up all three of these. And the idea is you kill all the vampires in Nosgoth. Eradicate the scum, the scourge of the earth. Something I just wanted to point out, and I know a bit more about it now. But now I'm gonna head back over to that warp gate. Get through there, Raziel. You can do it. Just believe. Although technically, he uses his will to phase through there. That's what the Elder God says. You can will your way through. Oh, I need to shift.
Yeah.
Alrighty, so that's it, boys and girls. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. I really can't remember where to warp to from here, but you will find out in part 4 at the very start. That's where I will be starting off from in part 4, is where you should be going right now. So, thank you for watching. Take it easy.